We're talking with George here. George Wilson, is it?
It is George Wilson, and I'm the impresario sight and sound.
Okay, and
of the Scabble Comet.
Okay, I thought you were like the Grand Poobah of clowns.
Well, we don't mess around. This is a Scottsville Philharmonic that I think for the however they've been running parades in Muskegon. You're in Muskegon, right?
Muskegon, right.
All right, Oscar. Well, how long they've been running, I think we start with the Seaway, and then whatever title you'd call that big parade in June,
okay.
We've been there.
Okay.
And right now, I understand we've received a lot of pressure. Oscar Osbo.
Right.
That's you.
Right.
I got this from a usually reliable source down in Muskegon.
Okay.
The Sheriff's Department. Sheriff Carter told me this.
All right.
He said he knows Oscar well.
Okay.
Your regular customer?
Not recently.
But he says that you have an enormous amount of talent. We heard about you last year, and we played a show for him. So I'm here we're actually going to invite you to march with the Scalpel Clawman this coming Saturday in Muskegon.
Oh, so I don't have to go through an interview or anything? I'm just invited?
Huh?
I'm invited.
You're invited.
Okay, now what did he say my talent was?
Well, your talent was making a lot of noise.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I do that.
And he said he'd been known to make a lot of noise and make a fool of yourself.
Yeah, I do that, right.
And that's probably the best qualifications you can to join our organization.
I'm very good at that. Yeah.
Now, I understand you play the Fenorton.
Okay.
I mean, there's not too many Fenorton players, you know, around.
Right,
and
right.
This is why we're really especially interested with you, because we had one, but he died, went to heaven.
Okay.
And we've been looking one ever since, and we found out you are a Fenorton player.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I've been.
Where did you learn the Fenorton, sir?
Where did I learn that? Well, yeah. I tell you what, my father from Norway, he brought the Fenorton over and he taught me.
So. Well, I thought it was Juilliard. Somebody said you did go to Juilliard.
Well, that was my cousin, Juilliard. Yeah.
Well, the Fenortons are in the family. But anyway, right. A Fenorton, of course, is a unique instrument that any place in the band that you walk with, whatever section, you blend right in.
Okay.
Including the drums.
All right. They've been telling me around here too that I don't need to dress up as a clown because I pretty much can.
Well, yeah, I've understood that when it comes to high fashion coutier, you ain't.
That's right.
Is that true?
That's true.
Well, yeah. You've got to remember we do insist on clean shorts and socks.
Yeah, that I can do.
Yeah, you can do.
Okay, I can handle that part.
Now, sir, we don't want you to be nervous because there's going to be thousands and thousands and thousands of people in Muskegon this coming Saturday.
Okay.
Yeah, that's one of the great all-time parades.
Right.
There is. Have you ever been in the great all-time parade in Muskegon?
I've ridden in the trunk once.
You were in the trunk? Yeah. Right. I mean, you cannot get out there and stroll among the masses.
Yeah, see, that's
man.
What I was wondering. That's a long parade. That goes on for quite a while.
Yes, it does. It's a great parade. I'll tell you, last year, and it was fantastic. Probably one of the greatest parades I've ever had. And they've had some great parades in Muskegon for many, many years, whether it was the Seaway or the Lumbertown or the Music Festival, whatever they call it.
Right.
They've had some great praise, but the last couple of years, I'll tell you, it's been the best ever.
Okay, Summer Celebration is what they call it now.
Summer Celebration.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, Muskegon's a great town.
It is.
And so we're going to send you a clown band code of honor and ethics.
Okay.
And you have to sign your name with in blood.
In blood.
But, you know, hey, we're just sort of like, you know, the boys, what do they call them, the happy fellows or the... Anyway... But, I mean, because, you know, we don't just turn anybody loose on the streets
right.
of Muskegon.
I understand that. Okay. Yes.
And meet us at the Muskegon Eagles.
All right.
And, again, like I said, clean shorts and socks.
Right.
And so you're Fenorton.
By Fenorton.
You're Fenorton. And do you play that in treble clef or bass clef?
I never got that far with Julia.
Well, of course, Fenorton, and regardless how you do it, it's there.
Right.
And we're looking forward to seeing you. Now, how will I recognize you? And, I mean, you know, there's a lot of people in Muskegon. Just every once in a while you see one of the strange ones. Now, I understand from many of your great friends in the Sheriff's Department, you're strange.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
How will I notice you right off the bat, sir?
I have very, very large, I have very, very large feet.
Large feet?
Yeah.
You got some anchors.
I got some anchors, yeah.
You got some anchors.
I got some ski boots.
Okay, well then, let's see. We'll meet you probably down at the Muskegon Eagles. That's on Western Avenue by the Heritage Park.
Okay.
Oh, and also, sir, we've also booked you. We're doing a show there afterward.
Okay.
When you get done in the parade, you're going to have you do 20 minutes of the soft shoe dancing and death-free parquet patter.
Okay.
You can do that.
And I can do it with the, I got to do it with the Phonorgan?
And then the Phonorgan, yes.
Okay. Out of curiosity, since it's such a long way, and I'm not used to walking that far, can I possibly rent a wheelbarrow or
a wheelbarrow?
Yeah. Is that a possibility?
Oh, hey, sir, this is Guts Parade. You get right out there, and you come right down Western Avenue.
I got to give my blood. I got to walk for miles.
Yeah, well, it's good for your soul. Good. And then, of course, at the other end, you get to Heritage Park. There's some good friends in Muskegon that have this rest and relaxation tent.
Okay.
We get you out of the hot sun. And get some cooling liquids into you.
Oh, okay.
That'll work. And they'll really buy you.
In the beverage tent.
Yeah, the entertainment tent.
Oh, okay. All right.
And we're really looking forward to this, Oscar. And remember, nobody in the Scalpel Clown Band ever finishes last.
One more time on that one?
Nobody in the Scalpel Clown Band ever finishes last.
Oh, okay.
So you've got to hold your own and with the Fornorton and then in the beverage tent.
Okay.
You can do that.
In the beverage tent, I think I'll be okay, but then with the Fornorton, I'm not sure.
Remember, Sheriff Kerr will be watching you.
Okay. I know Sheriff
Kerr. All right, sir.
All right, thank you very much, Joe.
Well, and have yourself a good day the rest of the way, and tell the good people of Muskegon that the Scalpel Clown Band, starring the one and only, I heard somebody say thank God in the background there, Oscar Oswald, right?
I guess. I'll be there.
All right, we'll see you, Oscar.
And all. Thank you,
Joe. Have a good time. Till then.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye now.
He did the right thing in turning himself in. So that's not too often you'll find someone do that. And
but what is it? Why is it a penalty to have 15 clubs? I don't know.
Well, because you can use a lot of extra. It's just one extra weapon in your bag. I mean, if you give pros an extra club, you'll see scores drop because they can have like an extra wedge.
Or those magical balls or something. Yeah.
No. It's it's like a lot of pros will carry two or three wedges and a different spin on the ball.
Okay.
Right. Listen to Press Box.
I'm not
springtime.
But I'm not a golfer.
We're gonna have some golf pros on. So.
Well, because I would have been a golfer, but I play miniature golf and I want to kill people. So I figured I better not. It's too stressful for me.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. That one story that we were talking about, they were talking about, I guess the Osgood Files. What was it? David Nicholas had a snowball's chance in heck when he battled bureaucrats over his backyard igloo. The Columbus, Ohio man built the igloo for his daughter, Rachel, using a homemade snowmaker machine and 6,000 gallons of water. The Columbus Department of Development told the family and the newly made mound of snow would not be allowed. But that was before the city building. Anyway, but it amazed me because here's all this water, all the snow to build this igloo for his. It doesn't say in here, but I think with the Osgood Files said his daughter was like 4 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, why would you want to put that much snow over a four-year-old girl? To me, I don't care whether it's safe or not. I wouldn't want to take the chance. I don't know if it was. Anyway, we wouldn't battle City Hall over it, but he thought it was safe for his daughter. But I don't know. 4 years old? Would you put a four-year-old? Would you put your daughter, in a thousand pounds
and
of snow over
I built? No.
See,
there you go. Maybe that's what I'm thinking, just because I know if I built something like that, it wouldn't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If I build it, I know. I absolutely not. But no,
it will collapse.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I don't know. I just thought it was kind of a silly story because why would you put 4,000 pounds of snow over a four-year-old?
The silly part to me is that the city says that he couldn't do it because he had to have zoning approval and
building.
Bureaucratic nonsense. Actually, that's redundancy. Bureaucrat and nonsense. But
It says that he built it without plans, permits, or inspections.
Yeah.
What was he going to put lights in the thing or what? You know.
I guess. Yeah. Wonder how he get his electrical code up.
Yeah, I was just going to ask you. It's a darn snow fort for Pete's sake.
Well, yeah, but I mean, I built snow forts in the backyard when I was a kid, but I mean, it wasn't 4,000 pounds of snow over my head. That was just a couple, ice blocks and stuff like that. I mean, that's probably what happened when it collapsed on me. But anyway, I just thought it was kind of silly.
Kids just can't have fun anymore, can they?
Well, I don't know, 4,000 pounds of snow or ice.
Well, I agree that that's probably a bit much, but
yeah.
I can't understand what would possess a father to do that.
Really? Poor Rachel. What is he going to build for in the summertime? I kind of wonder about that.
A tree fort they probably won't let him, though.
Yeah. Okay. Anyway,
put her up more than 6 feet in the air or something. She might fall.
Well,
and hurt
you got to in order to build a treehouse, you probably have to file an environmental impact statement.
Yeah.
Yeah.
because, you know.
Yeah. You're probably right. You're probably right.
I mean, you're damaging a tree.
I was
now.
Just going to say that. That's my air you're taking away from me with that tree, darn it.
We've got, we've got more Crim coming up. Also, Denise Mowry now is doing going to be doing an entertainment minute for us every day.
Ooh.
And it's going to be wonderful. Yeah, it's going to be special. And, of course, like we were saying before, we're going to be doing, of course, this doesn't include Scott. And he knows
nothing
it.
Ever includes Scott.
Well, just this one thing. We're going to be doing the movie review. If you want to,
no.
If you really want to, no. Maybe we can get you involved in it.
No.
But anyway, movie review on Mondays, and we'll be giving away Cinema 12 tickets and a Finley's gift certificate. Plus, we'll be talking from the gentleman from Lokes Theater, and he'll be discussing some of the movies that'll be coming up. We'll talk about the movies over the weekend. It'll be a movie extravaganza on Mondays.
Not with me. I'm emotionally ruined.
We all feel sorry for you, too. Really, we do. Okay, coming up next, Mort Crim, News Radio 850. And coming your way, we talked to somebody, over the Muskegon Heights. They're having the festival in the park, and that's going on today through Sunday. It started yesterday, I guess. Music, dance, basketball tournament, and all kinds of stuff happening over there. You gonna hit it?
I didn't. Sure.
Yeah, sure. Right.
I'll drive by it and check it out. I'm into amusement parks.
Yeah, well, it's right down Broadway, and supposedly there's gonna be a parade there. And see, I'm gonna be dressing as a clown, I guess.
Oh, so you're your normal everyday guard.
Yeah,
huh?
Basically, yeah. See, I have to interview from a gentleman who's in the clown band, and.
Oh, neat.
And so I got to see if I can have what it takes to be a clown. What do you think?
Oh, hands down. You got it.
But see, I have to interview it. I talk to some of these clowns to see how to dress, but everybody keeps telling me just to go the way I am.
Yeah. Don't even bother brushing your hair, Oscar. You'll do great.
Thanks,
We're
Deborah.
Behind you 100%.
Yeah, see, when they said that, I guess they just figured I just naturally fit that category. Oh, well. Anyway, Sports Roundup coming your way, and we'll be talking to Jeanette, and she's over there at the Muskegon Heights Festival in the park. At Soft Rock 95.3 News Radio 850. And Deborah, I have to apologize. I didn't mean to say it last just a little while ago that you were a lush and you went to every beer tent, okay? But isn't it amazing, though? Have you, in Ohio, when you lived in Ohio?
Oh, nothing. They're not beer tents in Ohio.
I know.
Only in Muskegon, Michigan.
That I know of.
Mm-hmm.
And bars close down when beer tents are in town.
I don't blame them.
It's amazing, a phenomenon around here. I don't know what it is about beer tents in Muskegon.
Well, when I moved here, I told people, well, they asked, what is Muskegon known for? And I had to tell them.
Beer
People
tents.
Who play.
People who play?
Yeah, with their beer tents. Yeah. Or in their beer tents.
Yeah, that's about it.
Yeah.
I mean, you get entertainment, you get beer tents, you have a party.
Mm-hmm. Especially during the summer here.
Yeah, yeah. I just don't. I mean, you figure you put a beer tent up in a bowling alley parking lot, you put it up at another parking lot over here, you find a parking lot, you got a beer tent, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know. I just don't quite understand the beer tent philosophy in Muskegon. But anyway.
Who needs a college party? You've got a beer tent here in
That's
Muskegon.
That's right. You know, because you and I both come from different areas of, I come from a different area of Michigan, and I still don't remember. And let's see, I've been in Traverse City, I've been in Hastings, been in Mount Clemens, been in all around that area.
Oh, they're kicking you out of each and every city.
They do, yes, they do. After a few years, they kick me out. But anyway, I don't remember any beer tents. I just
no,
don't.
Yeah.
I mean, I do remember beer tents, but not like we have them in Muskegon.
Yeah. Here, beer tent, McDonald's, you know.
It's a chain. It's a franchise in the summertime. Okay, anyway, I don't know. And of course, you don't go to any of them, just like I don't. And
oh, of course not.
Of course not.
I'm the chick popping a keg.
That's right. Mostly cloudy with a chance of showers and a high right around 70. Right now we have 63. And Deborah?
Yes?
I have my super glue.
Oh. And what are you going to do with it?
Well, Sherry Campbell brought this in because I asked her for it. Because the other day, you remember,
okay.
I got to share this story because you and I pretty much fit into this one. Okay, I was answering the phone.
Oh.
Somebody called me on the phone.
Yeah.
I went to answer my phone. And this phone is usually super glued down, but it broke loose. And it fell on the board, started a song, or turned off one of my songs. That's what it was. Turned off a song.
Uh-huh.
And I answered the phone, and it was you saying, let me out of the newsroom. My door handle fell off.
I was stuck. I was locked in.
So the phone fell apart. The door was falling apart. Hey, but we have our super glue now. We're okay.
You're going to fix my door handle, too?
Yeah, I'll fix the door handle. We'll glue it together. Everything will be glued here. My fingers, everything. Okay? I will not be able to leave my spot. But Sherry Campbell.
Don't call me so I don't have to unsuper glue you off of the board.
Oh, okay, there you go. Sarah Kimball's in here, and I'm going to talk to her, too, about with movie review, because you and I saw Congo, and the papers, from I think it was the Free Press, they kind of bashed it. And
did Sherry see it, too?
No, okay. But her and I saw, last week, we saw the movie
Bridges of Madison County.
Mm-hmm. And in the Chronicle, there was like a big write-up here about how wonderful this movie was.
You know, I heard a lot of good reviews on that, too. Many of them.
So I guess, well, I don't know. I'll talk to Sherry Kimball about this and see what she thinks about these reviews. And then you and I will talk about Congo and we'll
It's see just if we, your opinion.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I mean, I know we're not going to make or break Congo because we couldn't even find a seat.
True.
It doesn't matter what we say about it. We can just bash it to pieces if we wanted to, which I don't think I wish I won't.
It would fit the movie.
Huh?
It would fit the movie.
Okay. All right. Okay, so anyway, we'll be talking about that a little bit after 9, and I'll be using my super glue, but first I'll be talking to Cindy Jodes from the Frauenthal coming up next. 63.
Oscar. Yeah.
Yes.
Is it raining out now?
Is it raining out now?
Yeah.
I don't even know.
It just started raining.
Did it really?
Why don't you open up your window there, Oscar?
Do I have to? Oh, sure. Now I have two women to pick on me today. Good,
oh, it's
going
to be wonderful.
Okay.
The best part of life, isn't it?
I know it. We could just kind of kick him right out of here and take over.
Oh, no.
See ya.
Bye.
The reason I brought you here is now I'm starting to wonder, but anyway. As far as movie review, you did movie review with me last week.
Yep.
Sherry Kimball.
Yes, I did.
Okay. And the movie that we saw was The Bridges of Madison County. And we told Deborah not to see this movie. Right, Deborah? Remember the review we gave on this thing?
Yeah, it was pretty poor.
Yeah, neither one of us liked it.
But you were honest about it.
Yeah, well, it was 2.5 hours of Clint Eastwood and Meryl Streep trying to be sexy with love scenes with a PG-13 movie.
Was it PG-13?
Yeah.
What do you think it should have been?
It should have been PG-13.
Yeah.
I mean, you didn't see anything. I mean, not that you would want to anyway. It's just, it was just...
The review I heard said that Clint Eastwood was real vulnerable.
Uh-huh.
It's about as far as you'd put it.
There's only, okay, and the Chronicle here, it has a big ad, I'm sure that Cinema 12 put out, which is fine. I'm not trying to knock either one. I'm just saying that it says,